Yeah, hello all. In this particular video, I actually thought to introduce you to some of the program level cadences and portfolio level cadences. We all know that at a team level ceremony, as a part of the framework, we generally try to do the product backlog, the product backlog refinement, the planning of the sprint, and then we have our daily meetings, and then followed by your sprint review, retrospective, demo, right? So, but do we think that these particular team level cadences by themselves is going to sustain agility across the layers? So when I say layers, what I meant is you are at team level, and then you are program level, and then you are portfolio level. So in one of my LinkedIn article, I have actually written this particular post on what are all the program level cadences and the portfolio level cadences, which actually we can think through so as to have sustained agility across all the layers. Okay, so in this particular description of this video, I will be also sharing you the LinkedIn article link. You can just click and then take a read on it. Okay, now the point is to actually begin the journey. Let us actually understand the fundamental constructs. Generally in a project execution, irrespective of the methodology being used, whether it is a traditional waterfall model or it is an agile based engagement model, we actually still have something like a team level construct, something at a program layer construct, and then something at a portfolio level. So the point is that I am now going to tell you some of the program level cadences which we can think through to actually begin with. Okay, so one of the cadences which comes to my mind is feature backlog refinement. When I say feature backlog refinement, I am not actually talking about your product backlog refinement, which actually happens at the team level. I am talking about your features at a program layer being continuously refined on a regular cadence. Okay, the next thing is the PI targeting meeting. Okay, what it means? To actually decide which particular feature should go into which particular program increment. So, as a part of my flow orchestration, right, I have my, for example, if you take your 5 levels of agile onion planning model, you have your daily, you have your daily meetings, and on top of that, you have the planning of the sprint, and then you have your release planning, and then you have your product roadmap initiative, and then you actually have your strategy followed by the organization, right? Now, in this case, this PI targeting meeting is, it is going to tell if I'm going to pick up a particular feature to actually decide in which particular PI, to actually decide which particular feature should actually go into which particular program increment. Okay, let's say for example, in the case of a rally, if I'm actually taking a feature, say F215471, just an arbitrary number. Now this feature need to be properly parented to a sub-epic or a epic. Only then we will be having a vertical alignment. Now in this PI targeting meeting, what my teams used to do is, they used to decide this particular feature need to go into which particular program increment. Okay, it is program increment 2 or program increment 3, something like that. Okay, then we have something called as a release targeting meeting. Release targeting meeting is something which is going to decide which particular feature should go into which particular release, which is a go live. So we are trying to deliver it on a cadence, however we are trying to release it on a demand, because the fundamental thing is deployment to the production should always be driven by the client, in tune with the market rhythms and in tune with the business imperatives. Okay, and then Of course, you may need to do something like a precursor activity or a pre-readiness kind of a thing for a program increment planning, which you can, which I think much of the teams are already doing it. The next thing comes is the mid-PI review, means mid-program increment review, which is going to say, okay, in my program increment of 12 weeks, let's say if I have 6 sprint, means 2 week sprint, so 2 into 6, 12 weeks, after completing 2 sprint and probably half of the third sprint, or in time you can actually complete the 3 sprint, somewhere in the mid of the PI, I wanted to do a mid PI review. So if you take 12 weeks, in this case the example is very simple. If I take 12 weeks, if I have a 2 weeks sprint, so 2 into 6, 12 weeks, after completing the third sprint, I will be doing a mid PI review, mid program increment review, which is actually going to do the plan do check act, right? Which is actually going to do a PDCA cycle in the mid of the program increment. And then you can also do your PI level retrospective. You also do your release level retrospective. You can do your product owner sync up meeting. You can have a product manager sync up meeting. And you can, even you can have your agile coaches sync up meeting. And then you can have your SOS, wherein the multiple scrum masters come together and then do your sync up. In my case, I was actually working on a large scale safe implementation. Okay, at the time what I had somewhere close to 5 ARTs, and in 1 ART we had 17 teams, and in the second ART we had 5 teams. So depending upon the dynamics, the ART will be positioned strategically at a product line level or at an LOB level, and then we will be deciding how many teams need to be positioned onto the train. Now we had one more meeting called ART sync up meeting. So this ART sync up meeting is something we are trying to discuss about the dependencies across the trains. When I said one train, it is fundamentally team of teams. When I say ART dependency, across the trains, what are all the dependencies? And then we had something like an architect sync up meeting, wherein my system architect, my solution architect, those guys will have a sync up meeting. So what am I trying to say is, many people struggle at a team level ceremony like product backlog refinement, sprint planning, your daily stand up meeting, your sprint review demo, or your sprint retrospective, because there is no enough homework done at a program layer and a portfolio layer. If you do enough homework at a program layer and at a portfolio layer, by the time you start doing your team level ceremonies, all the benefits will start flowing to the team. Okay. Now, one more example to actually touch upon the portfolio level cadences is, I have actually introduced something called epic and sub-epic cleanup, wherein we will be continuously refining the epic and sub-epic, and also trying to impose the WIP limits, work in progress limit, on my portfolio Kanban board in the rally. So if I take the flow state of the epic, it is something like discovery, define, design, implementation, done, deploy. Right, which is one thing. And then the second thing what I have done is product road mapping and review, wherein I am trying to align the outcome of epic and sub-epic cleanup pertaining to the road mapping journey. Okay, am I funded the right epic? Is this particular epic is really a priority for me? And then I followed by one more cadence called investment themes funding meeting, wherein I do a dynamic budgeting at a lean portfolio management. Okay, using a participatory budgeting concept, or I can put a horizontal guardrails. Okay, and maybe some of the tools like a target process can also be used to do the dynamic budgeting. And then I have something called a EBCM, which is called as Enterprise Business Capability Model, right? Or rather Enterprise Business Capability Mapping, wherein we are trying to see, okay, I have taken this particular epic in my rally. This particular epic is part of which particular investment theme? Is it a part of Factory of Tomorrow, or is it a part of Run and Protect? Is it a part of which particular BAU? Why am I going to fund it? And map this and map your portfolio KPI to this particular investment theme. So these are all some of the program level and portfolio level cadences which I am which I'm doing for the past six and a half years. I just wanted to tell to the audience, going forward, if you have challenges in your product backlog refinement or your sprint planning, probably you have not done enough justice at a program layer or at a portfolio layer. So sometimes the solution to the problem is not exactly where the problem is. You may need to look one level above or a couple of levels above to actually do a root cause analysis of the problem. Okay, so as part of my this particular Agile mentorship program, couple of days back, one of my mentee was actually asking me, like, what do you mean by this continuous flow of a value or continuous planning? Can you give me an example? Okay, I actually told him, when you go to the seashore, what happens? One wave after the wave, one wave after the wave keeps on coming and hitting the shore, right? One wave comes, it goes back, second wave. So the planning need not be confined to a meeting called feature backlog refinement, need not be confined to a meeting called program increment planning. So first we need to come out of that particular mindset, because in an agile driven engagement, which is more of a value driven and more of an adaptive nature, planning is a BAU. Planning is a continuous activity based on the rolling wave approach, based on the progressive elaboration. However, these cadences give a touch point for collaboration, communication, coordination. Okay, let me actually repeat this line, because I found it to be very important. These meetings only give a touch point for us to collaborate better, communicate and then coordinate in a formal setup. That actually does not necessarily mean planning need to be done only in that meeting, because in the past I have seen many of the teams, they come to program increment planning, then they will try to understand the feature. Absolutely no. Because in my teams, as a part of my coaching, after 15 to 18 months, we have actually reached a maturity level where everything flows in a self-sustained manner. Everything flows in an autopilot mode. But then it has taken 15 to 18 months of hard work behind it. Lot of extensive planning, focus grouped workshop, and commitment and continuous improvement mindset was there. So when you have that continuous improvement mindset or a growth oriented mindset, I do think the planning will also happen on a continuous basis, so that when the meeting comes, people can come together to actually present it and to discuss that dependencies. So before I actually end this video, just to cut a long story short and to paraphrase it, the intent of this video is to tell, it is not enough if you want to sustain agility across the layer. It is not enough if you just do team level ceremonies. You find out your program level cadences. You find out your portfolio level cadences, which makes utmost relevance in your own landscape. Of course, within the constraints, of course, within the available means. Whatever I have given here is just an example. When my client changes the landscape, I will also come up with some dynamic cadences. Because if you don't have dynamic cadences, then what's the point of talking about agile and agility? Responding to change over following a plan, while we have value on the right, the value on the left is more than a value on the right. Right, so that Agile manifesto, the 12 principles of Agile or the 9 or 10 principles of the SAFe need to be echoed or imbibed in whatever I am doing and whatever I am not doing also. Okay, so let me end this video by again saying that if you have any challenges, real-time challenges, you can please feel free to connect with me. Let's see what is the value that I can actually add to you. Okay, cheers, bye.